Let's hit the resume. It is the last day of the year, Monday the 31st of December, 2018. Thanks for joining us today. And we're off. And as always, let the market settle in a little bit. Prove to them that it deserves your money. Spider jumping up into kind of no man's land here. We had 250 as a target earlier. Let's look here. One day, five. Okay, never mind. Apple. Apple could be a long over 158.75. Apple could be a short under 158. We're just under 2 minutes into the markets. Is my LTA not working? came along to January calls, 155 calls for Apple. Chase that, I couldn't get it to fill. All right, out one. Locked in the profits there for the first call. A Bally 159, Mr. Apple. Let me see what was there. Well, 60-minute chart. I'm seeing probably we're going to have more like 160.50 or something like that as a major obstacle. This is a 2-day 15. See, it's above 158.50. going to set a stop at break even. I'm out. And right. It was 35. I was out flat on the last one, plus 35. Didn't make a lot, but hey, you know. I had trouble chasing. I should have probably made about 50 to 75 bucks on that one. I will keep an eye on it. Okay, let's look at the spiders. Still struggling with 250, the 5 minute chart. You can see that, how it's doing that. Let's see what SPSX is doing, maybe over 3120. We could be all about a lot about nothing here, which in kind of influenced me to take smaller share size, like 2 instead of 4 on Apple calls, and take profits early because I have no idea whether we're going to get a follow through or not. Alright, the LTA is working now. These are the 2 day highs here. Tandem, TNDM. Tandem's looking pretty good actually. As on the hourly, the daily, not so bad. We're reaching $39 possible resistance. So if you went long, you'd have to watch and see what it does there. Weight Watchers is a almost a 52-week low. All right, let's look at some of the stocks that we had on our list. Team is still going up. Send didn't trigger yet, nor Seattle Genetics or AF. Scanner Group looks like it might be trying to roll over, but it is in an uptrend. Overstock is in a downtrend, looks like it wants to roll over. That's probably the best short. And along with ServiceMaster, SERV. They're battling it out there. Cannot figure out which way they want to go. Serve below about 36. What was the low on Friday? Yeah, under 36.20 or so. A low, Friday low. Apple shorts coming into play. Tandem still going. RDS, I don't know that I would like that. Little Dutch Shell, not so bad. Be careful though. Service Master, keep an eye on it below 36. Apple broke below 158.5. Next target is the low of the day, 158. 1. $395. Watching that 158, see if it can break below that, or is it just going to do a, if I assume that this was a fill here, so this would look like a flag pattern, but doesn't look to be that way. Looking to sell another at 410. Should fill right now. Only got 2 left. I'll manage that a little bit. Let's see if this is pushed down lower here in Apple. SPSX looks like a long right now or possible towards the gap fill. You're probably looking at, I'm looking at the weekly, sorry, 11 Jan 19, so it's not the monthlies, my bad. Out another 1, so I've only got 1 left. Way to go, Bob. Sorry about that, folks. I misspoke. The longs I was in January, monthlies. In fact, I probably should have been in January monthlies on both of them. I already had this one up from last week, so I traded it and probably should not have. It doesn't necessarily have the best, yeah. Sorry about that, Coach and Stu. I did not mean to confuse everyone. Now, Apple's fighting going lower. You're going to raise the frog? Excuse me. We're at, yeah, there we go. Come on, lower, 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 Apple. Come on. I'd probably be happy to get $150 to $200 today on a holiday, basically. Even though we are open the whole day, I don't see that happening, really. Okay, I went ahead and flattened out with that little 430 on the last one. Okay, 50, 110. All right, 125 plus 35, about 160 for the day so far. Said trying to make sure I trade quickly, meter drop type stuff. Let's see what SPSX U Pro. Probably a pretty good time to sell. All right. Way to go, Doug, and thank you very much for posting, you and Bob both. Thank you. Always glad to see what other people are doing. Thanks, Stu. I'm of the persuasion that you could probably just trade Apple most of the day and in and out longs and shorts. As long as you don't get too greedy, don't want to just make it do the setup properly. And here's the 3-minute Apple that we got today. We pull down to this level over here. If you look over here to the left, you've got a little bit of a rectangle. Let me make that tan. Beach Buff. See, we got right to the top of that level right there and reversed. I didn't quite see it, but I can see it now. Whoops. I need to pull it holding down. U-Pro looking pretty good here. Spiders looks like it wants to attack 250 again. VIX gap down and looks like it kind of rolling over here down towards the low of the day. Qiagen, Q-G-E-N. Looks like it's running. It's above a 10-day high. So looks like it has room above. AutoNation. Over 35.75. Runs to 37 something. Marvell. We are in a seasonal bull period, but this has not been our normal periods this year. So not sure how much credence to put into that. Yeah, gap and snap. It looks like it may want to bounce back up to about 133-ish or something like that, and then you could possibly get on board again. Yeah, it has a level around 133. Well, looks like it still wants to go lower. Amazing. Watch 131.50 on it, but we can't go short here. Where's the stop? Only problem I've got. There's 131.50 in Facebook. All right. Day trades or swings? What are you looking at? Agen and DVAX, you posted. Are they swings or are they day trades? What time frame you're trading those? Okay. Just curious. All right, we're talking about 10:05. We're at our first major reversal time, 10 a.m. Right now, as far as the spiders go, they're in kind of gap up and flat. And SPSX, UPRO, all pretty much flat. The VIX is backing off a bit. Think so? Let me look at the spreads. How's the spreads for you on DVAX? Not too bad. With those wicks, I thought maybe it'd have been a little wider. All right. Yeah, the problem with the smaller stocks that don't move a lot, you sure have to buy a lot of shares though, don't you? That's why I usually pick on stocks over about $25. Not always. Well, we're seeing a lot of biotechs getting a bid today. You're in the right sector there, Coach. LABU is up 5%. Look a little weak at the moment. Immunogen. SGMO. NTLA. Ions, MRTX, those are all just ones that are showing up on the big movers, and they're all pharmaceutical biotechs. Team is up at $90. Looks great on the daily. We're doing a mini breakout. This $90 level is critical though. HLF up near 59, that's also a critical level. Looking for Baidu to possibly roll over. Let's see what Bob is doing. Also keep an eye on Baba. Both shorts. Overstock's already rolling over below that $14 level. I'm not going to short it. I'm going to take that off the list. Don't even waste my time. Shutterfly. We just have to be patient. Maybe in the early in the new year we'll have some good setups here. I am kind of seeing Nothingville right here. Apple's going a little bit lower, getting a little long in the tooth, and the stochastics RSI looks like it wants to try to bottom. The easy money's been made in Apple right now, on the short side. And this 15-minute and 5-minute on the spiders show not a lot. Let's go back to my standard. I was bouncing around a lot, and so therefore I took off this the link here. There's serve, but we're basically nowhere. I mean, I'm bringing these up because the dailies, I'm actually looking at the daily charts, not 5 minutes, because the five, I start with the daily. Let's see, there's Crocs. We got dark cloud cover here. What's it going to have to do? We're in an uptrend. I'd probably think that that's not one I want to try to short. Face plant, that does look like a swing short. So you could potentially day trade it short as well. Deckers is an uptrend, so I wouldn't want to short that puppy. SCG, still in an uptrend, so I'm not sure I want a short unless I give a really bad signal here. Shutterfly, different story. There was a reverse of the mean. We're not at Shortsville yet until we get below about 39. Scanner group, we already talked about. Although this one's in an uptrend, but if we continue lower here, we've made a lower high and a lower low or an equal low. There's Baidu and Baba are both similar. There's Baba. Baba gapped because it had a settlement with the state of California. Workday. Workday's a little bit difficult to go short because we're in an uptrend. I'm using basically the 50-day. Tesla's kind of in no man's land. Herbalife is retesting the highs, along with Team, that $90 level I talked about. And Eli Lilly. Lily could have been a good one today. I'm trying to be very, very conservative today, on top of the normal conservatism. I'm treating today as a Friday before a holiday weekend, basically. And Apple's going lower. Interesting. Let me look at Apple. Let me look at, you see the problem, Coach, is that if I do that, sometimes I get duplicates. If I want to trade it, I have to take it off, and then I have to remember to, put it back on. Apple's crapping out with the markets. Let's analyze that one. You can probably trade the 11 Jan weeklies in Apple, but maybe you'd be better off spending a little bit more. Don't know. 11 days out. The weeklies definitely have more volume and open interest. Stuff happens there, you know. On days like this, like I said earlier, I tend to cut back on the quantity and take profits earlier than rather than later, so it doesn't disappear. I've had it happen that way too many times for me. I wouldn't get too excited about going short the markets here. I guess it could come back quite a bit, but I feel a little uneasy. Uneasy queasy. Nuvasiv is on the list here, 5-day high. Let's see what it looks like. Yeah, just a pinball, basically. Pinball setup. Too spready for Nuvasiv for me. At 10:18, and we still got a 10-cent spread. No. I'm not playing that game. All right, let's look at SPY on a 5-minute here. I'm going to fill this in right here and say that that's a wide range bar. And that right there is approximately a 50% retrace. Stochastics RSI down at the bottom, which is one of the, this is why I said be careful. It could go lower, but it could just reverse right here. I'm going to call NetEase NetTease. It keeps opening up positive and then giving it back. Open it up positive and giving it back. You bastard. We're in no man's land as far as I can see about the spiders, Qs, same pretty much. GDX, GDXJ, not really giving me anything. Nugget, eh. Or JNUG, eh. Watch for another push in the biotechs again. LABU. 5-cent spread. It does have room on the daily up to about 40 if it can do that. The momentum's getting a little late. It's not, let's put it this way, it's not early. Tough to trade that one. The VXX is backing off. ABMD, I'm looking at it from right here. I'm gonna look at ABMD offline on the side on my TC2000 to look at the daily. It's a $320 stock. And Coach, you may want to keep an eye on these two columns here, the 5-minute high and 5-minute lows. I've set them for twos, but see, like OKTA is a 5-minute. I think it was too cheap for me or something, too big. Yeah, the spreads are too wide. 16 to 18 cent spreads right now. I didn't even see the spread in ABMD. Bid's 328.27. The ask is 329.91. No, thank you. QLD. Are you long from 66.50? I don't understand the 0.5, Dave. Ah, okay, 50% retrace. Okay, gotcha. Yep. We kind of did that once before. We're still in a downtrend from what I'm looking at on the QLD on a 5. I'm seeing this as kind of a... I'm having trouble drawing straight. Do we kind of break up? This first one was really encouraging because it came back to this level here and bounced, then it failed. I think they're going to just try to mess with us all day. Now that I've got a little bit of money, and I emphasize the word a little bit, of money in the bank, I'm going to probably be very selective for anything more. 10:25, approaching the bottom of the hour reversal. So we could either get a push, we could get a rollover, no idea. the first time on the short, an apple was about a dollar. This one was anywhere between 50 to 75 cents. So I think we get a bit of a bounce at apple. We also are in this kind of downtrend here. We got to break that downtrend. And more than likely, I'd make it break a 158 before it actually, I don't know, not before I trade it, but 158, it will take a break and a hold above that to change the trend. But we could get a bounce. Oops. Let's say we get a bounce to 158 or a slight penetration and a roll back and a push back up. That could be in the cards to change the trend. Q's still looking weak to me. Spider had a volatility flip on the 5 minute from up to down. No change in trend for Apple for quite some time here. And when Apple did this bounce over here, this was a an opportunity for a short, a reversion to the mean. I think we get a little bit of a bounce in the markets here. It's not tradable for me. We're still in a downtrend. I trade in the direction of trend mostly. My sin did not roll over. Netflix appeared here. Let's take a look at it. Coming up in resistance area. All right, 10:30 now, and the S&P's plus 13, the Dow up 188, the NASDAQ up 40, Russell, whoops, oh good Lord, get there, okay, Russell is down 2.3, the VIX is down to 26.60, All right, folks, I need to take a couple of minutes break. I will be right back. And now be careful. A lot of times when I step away, the markets start to move. Yeah, hello.
Hello, hello, hello.
This is your Publix pharmacy.
Yeah, I forgot to go get it yesterday. I know.
Okay, it looks like the markets are trying to pull back. We'll see. Or they're trying to suck people in. Who knows? We could get fooled quite a bit here. Low volume holiday trading. Careful. Apple's a lot weaker than I expected it to be. I'm going to go on with the mic off and mute. I'll come back up if I see anything. Well, the SPY is pulling back, SPXX, trying to go higher. It's at the high of the day. It's only 31.40. Did a little bit of an intraday J hook, but it was hard to buy. It's just very hard out there. I mean, there aren't really great entries, in my opinion. Nothing fantastic. Hey, Stalker, good morning. Happy New Year. TZA. TZ had a pretty good run off the bottom from 15 to 1565. Looking at a 5 minute. That was mostly yesterday, Friday. I'm not seeing a whole lot. 10:45. Biotechs are still a little hot. CRISPR Therapeutics, CRSP, daily looks okay. Let's look what the spready, too spready. 15, 18 cents. Not a lot. Sorry about that, folks. looking at Apple and its trend is down. I'm looking at the SPY, the trend is down. We've got to make higher highs and higher lows. Probably watch the volatility dot. Make it break, you know, higher highs, higher lows. FRC. Do yada da 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 da. Boring. Thank you. Grace, here are the largest components of the QQQs. Apple makes up just under 10%, Microsoft over 10. So if you look at these, and I'm gonna go over here to TC2000. I'm gonna go to the Qs. I'm gonna go right here, look at the components. And we'll go to market cap. Let's see what they're doing. They should be all about the same. Facebook's a little weaker. So is Comcast. So basically, which comes first, the chicken or the egg? I would not know how to answer that, really. They're probably going to be pretty much lockstep. I'm surprised to see PepsiCo in that list. The spiders are going down. Apple just doesn't seem to be at the moment. Okay, folks. Today's the last day of the open house. If you like what you see, we have a 30-day trial. You can sign up there, only $14 for right now. All the prices are likely to go up in the month of January. So take advantage of signing up at least for a trial if you like what you see. Want to sign up for a monthly or whatever, that's okay as well. I will, way to go, soccer. I'm a little proud of this, so I'm gonna, you know, break my arm, pat myself on the back here. Well, on the first part when we had, when I was doing the futures, I only had $8,000, but then, we backed off to the stocks and ETFs. I started trading my one of my retirement accounts, and it only had $61,000. So not a lot. Another reason I can't take on too many more shares, maybe 400 shares max. Okay, here's the link to the performance. I'm going to call it the 8 month profits were $22,565, even though today is technically December. The week is really the new year. So the performance will kick over through a January 19. Now I also, because I've been in a retirement account, I don't have to comply with the they don't actually hold me to the clearing rules or whatever. Even though, you know, obviously I'm over the 25,000 pattern day trader, but as long as I'm out, I don't have to wait 3 days for the money to clear. But you gotta check with your broker. Do I have a link to a quarterly membership? Let me look. I'm not sure if they set it up. I think they did. Okay. Okay, look here at the bottom of this page here. 97.25 a month, 261, 10% discount for a quarterly, 21% off for, let me show you. 10% off for quarterly, 21% for the monthly, and 36% off if you subscribe for an annual. And Karen, I say welcome to a neighbor. We love to go, if we go to any beach at all, it's always New Smyrna. Love it there. No, we used to when our kids lived in the house. My daughter lives in England now. She was in London for a while. Now she lives on the outskirts. Outskirts. She lives a 1 hour train journey north. And son's not in the house. I don't go with him to the beach. He wouldn't do that with me. He'd be ashamed to be seen with me, I guess. Last time, I'm trying to remember the last time we went. It's been a few years. Markets are looking a little weak here. You see the spiders going down, but the apple is not. Apple refuses to go lower. I wouldn't come over there for bike week. No, there would be, the crowds would be way too much for me. And I'm not a biker. So I'm not sure I would fit in very well. Way to go, Doug. You're on fire this today here. If you guys have any questions, please feel free to ask. I am going to post out some links here to my YouTube channel. Feel free to sign up. Those, there are a couple of videos that I think are definitely worth watching, and one of them is an overview session, a little impromptu overview. One about how we trade here. And all right, I'm going to show you guys and gals how to get the, you will not be sent the new password. What you do before, anytime starting tomorrow, go out and get, do member login. Go ahead and log in. Go to the, this will show your memberships. Click on Top Gun Trading. And at the very top, it will show you the password. Currently, it's B-52. And you'll get another one at, that will be reset late this evening. So come in tomorrow or on early on Wednesday, and you will find it after logging in. If you use the contact page or whatever, it may take us a while to get to you, but you, so you need to remember how to get the password. Okay, the other thing is, if you log in, go to member e-learning. And this talks about, it was in, recorded 15 November. And it's an in-depth review of setups and strategies. More than you saw on the free site YouTube. Okay, I have a few things I want to post here. There's an intro to day trading. Let me make sure that it actually opens. Opens for me. Okay, close that. Yes, we try to do it at least once a month, Karen, for members only. A lot of times we'll get kind of impromptu sessions during the day. Favorite chart patterns, post-trade analysis, reversal times, share sizing. I'll make sure each one of those open. does. Post trade. Open. It works. Reversal times. Open. It works. Exercising. Open. Yeah, it's, well, on the 15, it's just trying to make a bottom. I'd be very careful. This is not a V bottom yet. Right. I posted the wrong. Try that share sizing chart. I think it's basically the same. Yeah. They're the same. They're just named differently. One is a PDF and one is an Excel spreadsheet. Okay, we've just gone past 11. I'll only be here about another 10 minutes or so, and then I'm going to call it a year. I will leave everything up in case other people want to trade. I would strongly recommend and suggest that you treat this like a Friday, and Friday before a three-day weekend, and that you do not trade on Friday afternoons. They usually end up, you know, zipping it around and going basically nowhere. My journal entries proved to me that Fridays were a bad day to trade in the afternoon. Afternoons, in fact, were times that I usually gave money back to the market that I made in the morning. So once I get close to my goals, I tend to stop or to slow down quite a bit. Once I reach my goal, I will stop. I haven't met my goal for the day, but I'm close enough that I'm basically going to make a perfect entry before I get into anything. And I didn't see any perfect entries in either direction. If anybody has a question after looking at any of that stuff, and you want to ask me any questions whatsoever, you can use topguntrading2@gmail.com, or you can use the contact page from either one works. So much for the move up on SPY. Looks like SPSX gonna break 3160. Momentum's just okay. The markets are too tough to trade right here. Too tough. Apple's struggling with 157.5. as it, you can see how I drew the key levels on SPSX, the markets tend to move from swing level to swing level. Resistance level and support levels. That's why I marked them up. Apple is giving a sell signal if you're long, not necessarily a short though. We're kind of in no man's land on the longer term direction. As we can see, the SPY 15 minute and 5 minutes are both in solid downtrends. Getting a bounce on Apple. Little bounce in the markets. Could this just be a reversion to the mean? We've had those two or three times. Let's see. I'd be watching Apple over 157.60. SPSX could not get over 3180, at least so far. Watch for Apple over that 157.60 to get a bit of a pop. All right, it's 11:30 Eastern. I do not allow myself or my trading plan to initiate new trades after this time. Until, say, an afternoon trading, and I'm treating it as a Friday. There goes Apple. We got a little bit of a pop. See if it follows through, or is it just... Yep, there goes SPY a little bit, too. Let's look and see the Qs. Yep. Qs need to get over 153.5. You too, Coach. All right, I am going to call it a year. I will leave my charts up in case you guys want to use them. And let's do day 15. Dink. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. Okay. All right, folks. We'll see you on the flip side. Take care.